Good evening. Good evening to my students. I will wait until all of you attend the meeting, or the majority of you. Good evening. Please respond to my voice. Hello. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Assalamu alaikum.
Assalamu alaikum. Okay. This Zoom meeting, I will record this Zoom meeting and I will put the record on the YouTube channel. Okay. Okay. Are you hearing well? Do you hear my voice?
Yes.
Yes, okay. If there is any defect in the communication, please phone me, call me on my mobile so I can shift to the mobile hotspot. If there is any defect in the communication, if you don't hear me.
All right.
Do you hear my voice clearly? Because I will start now. Do you hear my voice? Why you don't speak? Please speak. Do you hear my voice?
Yes, hello.
Okay, yes, okay, I will start now.
All right.
Okay, please, I will try to do my best to catch up the 3 weeks that you have lost, okay? You have lost about 3 weeks of lectures. So I will try to catch these 3 weeks, but at the meantime, you should attend the lectures at the faculty because I will insist for all instructors to speak in English, okay? Please, you should attend the lectures at faculty, okay? Because we may not have enough time to finish with me all the syllabus. I will do my best to catch up the first 3 weeks, okay?
All right.
Okay, please answer on me because to make sure that you hear me. This is the first lecture. I will begin with carbohydrate chemistry.
Okay.
Carbohydrates are organic molecules. Organic means inside the organic, the living organisms, inside the cell of the living organisms. Carbohydrates are compound composed of carbon and water. Carbon, there is a number of carbon atoms. There may be 3 carbon atoms, 4, 5, 6, 7. If you have three carbon atoms, you should have three molecules of water. If you have four carbon atoms, you should have four molecules of water. Hence the name carbon and hydra. Hydra means water. Is this clear?
Yes.
They are polyhydroxy alcohol. Poly means multiple hydroxyl group. Carbohydrates contain multiple hydroxyl group. This is the hydroxyl group I make. It's better that I will make a marking on the light show. This is the hydroxyl group. Do you see the mouse? Hydroxyl group in the organic molecule is an alcoholic group. This is an alcohol. Please close the microphone because there is a noise. Shut your microphone because there is a noise. Okay, hydroxyl group in any organic compound is an alcohol. So this is multiple hydroxyl group, multiple alcohols in the carbohydrate molecules. Carbohydrate has another name, which is glycans. Okay? Carbohydrates are classified into monosaccharides, disaccharides, oligosaccharides, polysaccharides. What's the meaning of mono? Have you heard the lecture that I put on the YouTube?
Yeah.
Yes.
Not sure.
What is the meaning of mono? Mono. What is mono?
One
sugar molecule. One sugar, glucose is one molecule, only one. This is the building unit of carbohydrate, one sugar molecule. This one sugar molecule may have three carbon atoms. It is termed triose. Ose means sugar. Tri means three. If it has four carbon atoms, it is tetrose. Tetra means four. If it has five carbon atoms, it is termed pentose. Penta means five. If it is six carbon atoms, it is termed hexose. You have to know the classification. Which sugar belong to which classification, but you don't have to know the formula. The formula is not required to study them or to memorize them, okay? So, glucose, one sugar molecule, it is monosaccharide. If you have two sugar molecules linked together by covalent bond, it is disaccharide. Di means two, two sugar molecules, two glucose molecules linked together by a very strong bond called covalent bond. This is disaccharide. Oligo. Oligo means little. Oligosaccharide, there is little number of sugar molecules. Small number, from 3 to 10 sugar molecules. Do you hear me clearly? Please answer. Do you hear?
Yes, teacher.
Oligosaccharides contain from 3 to 10 sugar molecules. Polysaccharide contains hundreds of sugar molecules. Actually, hundreds and thousands of sugar molecules. Is this clear? The classification is clear? You understand it?
Yeah.
Yes. Okay. Why carbohydrate is important in our diet? Because the major source of energy we get from our food is from carbohydrate. The majority of our diet is carbohydrates, okay? To give us enough calories by oxidation, by metabolism, our body, we get energy to survive, to carry the biological function. Please shut your... mute your microphone because there is a noise. Shut your microphone because there is a noise and interruption. There is distraction, okay?
Doctor, others are not getting your voice.
You don't get my voice?
Me, I'm getting your voice, but others are outside there. They are saying that they are not getting your voice. I don't know what is wrong with their phones.
There is a noise. I hear a noise on my computer.
You yeah, don't they are trying noise, to get your voice.
Actually, I am the host. I hear a noise. Somebody
yeah.
in their microphone, and there is a noise in their house. Okay? Please mute your microphone. Shut your microphone down. The major part of energy from our diet is from carbohydrate. The storage form of energy. Do you know some people in Palestinian country, they deprive themselves from food for several months. Do you hear that in the news? They refuse to take food for several months. Do you hear that?
Yeah.
How can they get energy without food? How can their body survive for several months without any feeding? Because there is a store of energy in our body. Some of the stored energy in our body is from carbohydrates. Okay?
Yeah.
Some of the component of the cell membrane is carbohydrates. Some components in the cell membrane, like receptors, channels, sodium channel, potassium channel, contains also carbohydrates. Monosaccharide. Anybody answer me, please. What is monosaccharide?
One unit of sugar.
One sugar molecule. You have to memorize examples of triosis. Some examples of sugar molecule which contains carbon atom. You have to know example of tetrose which contain 4 carbon atom. Example of pentose. Example of hexose. Example of heptose. Of course, we will study them now. And all these are monosaccharides. Monosaccharides are classified according to the presence of aldehyde or ketone group. And we will see now what's aldehyde and what's ketone. If the monosaccharide contains aldehyde group, it is aldoses. If the monosaccharide contains ketone group, it is ketoses. Okay? Please look at this molecule. I move my mouse about the molecule. How many carbon atoms in this molecule?
Three.
Look at this molecule.
Three
carbon atoms. It is termed D-glycoside. Do you see it? 3 carbon atoms. It is D-glyceraldehyde. This is a carbohydrate. This is triose. Contains 3 carbon atoms. Why I said this is a carbohydrate, not a lipid. This is a carbohydrate. This is not protein. This is not a lipid. Because it contains multiple alcohol group. I said hydroxyl group. Do you see this hydroxyl group?
Yes.
I move my mouse. Do you see my mouse moving?
Yeah, we are seeing.
The mouse that I move? Okay. This is another hydroxyl group. Multiple hydroxyl group. This is a carbohydrate. Hydroxyl here is an alcohol. This is not alkali. This is not alkali, such as sodium hydroxide. This is not alkali. This is alcohol. Why? Because this is an organic molecule. Okay?
But, Prof, I have to...
You have a question? Anybody have a question?
Yes, I have a question. Can you repeat a bit on that one?
I repeat.
Yes.
You see, I will make a view, another view.
Then you will buy the okay.
You see that? Do you see the red color? Do you see the red pen around the hydroxyl group? Do you see it? Do you see the hydroxyl group that I draw around by the red pen?
Of course.
Yeah.
Yes, multiple hydroxyl group equal carbohydrate. This is an alcoholic group. Why this is an alcohol? because it is attached to carbon and hydrogen. This is an alcohol, multiple hydroxyl group, polyhydroxy alcohol. This is a carbohydrate. How I know this carbohydrate? Because it contains also aldehyde. This is an aldehyde group. This is an aldehyde group. CHO is an aldehyde group. So this is aldose. Aldose means carbohydrate which contains aldehyde group. Type. Can you see the other molecule on the left side? It has the same name. It has the same name. This is glyceraldehyde and this is glyceraldehyde. Do you find any difference between the two molecules?
Yes.
What is the difference?
Yes. Hydroxyl group on the right side in the D sugar. Hydroxyl group on the left side on the L sugar. Do you find the difference? Glyceraldehyde and this is glyceraldehyde. So they are isomers. They are called optical isomers. Optical because they make a change in the direction of the light. The direction of the light.
But Prof, we have the question.
Yes. What is your question?
Can you hear?
My question
is that what really causes the difference in the change of the hydroxyl in on the left and on the right? Is there any reason?
We find these sugar in nature. We find
that's the way they are.
One sugar has hydroxyl group to the right and the other sugar have hydroxyl group to the left. They are isomers. They are the same. Okay. Glyceraldehyde and glyceraldehyde. Both of them are glyceraldehyde.
Okay.
The one which contains hydroxyl to the right is called the D sugar. The one which contains to the left is called L sugar.
Okay, so on the L, on the L
directions.
On the L sugar, why is it oxygen on the first and then hydroxyl? Why is it OH instead of HO?
No. How can be this? We are talking about alcohol group.
This is OH and this is OH. Both of them are hydroxyl group. Both of them are hydroxyl, but found in different directions.
Okay.
You said something which I missed concerning the structure of glyceraldehyde, the CH2OH. Are we not going to call her alkanal group?
Alcohol group. OH is an alcohol group.
Alkanal, not alcohol.
Not alkaline. Alkaline, it should be attached to a metal. To a metal such as sodium and potassium. This is not a metal. It's attached to carbon and hydrogen.
I'm talking about carbonyl group. Because containing alkanal and alkanol, I think this is alkanal.
This is not an alkaline. This is alcoholic group. This is aldehyde group. This is aldehyde group, okay? All these are aldoses because it contains aldehyde group.
Call Angie to come to the door and go with my sister.
Again, because we don't have time, I'm going to shift to ketosis. If you look at this group, please, one speak at a time. One student speak at a time because there is a noise. Okay? These are ketosis. Ketosis contains carbon and oxygen. This is a ketone group which contains carbon and oxygen. Okay? How many alcohol group in this molecule? On a dihydroxyacetone, how many alcohol group?
Two
alcohol group. This is an alcohol. And this is an alcohol. Why it is an alcohol? Why? Because it is attached to carbon and hydrogen. Okay? This sugar contains how many carbon atoms?
Three
carbon atoms.
triose. It is termed triose. Okay? I'm going to shift. Aldo, you have to memorize and to study this table by heart. This table come in the exam. Okay? If you have aldehyde group, this is an aldehyde group. Carbon, hydrogen,
oxygen.
Aldehyde, the sugar is called aldose. And this is aldotriose. Contains the three carbon atom and the aldehyde group, glyceraldehyde, okay? This sugar contain four carbon atom and aldehyde group. It is termed aldotetrose. You should study by heart erythrose, the example. You should know the erythrose. This sugar contain five carbon atom, aldopentose and aldehyde group. You have to study and memorize ribose and xylose. This sugar contain six carbon atom, aldehyde group. It is termed aldohexose. And the examples, three examples. Glucose, mannose, galactose. Okay? The other class, I have to divide the table. The other class contain ketone, carbon, and what?
Hydrogen.
La, not no hydrogen.
What I know.
Double bond.
And oxygen.
No, and oxygen.
Because you have to keep silent.
Oxygen and carbon. This is called ketone group. Ketone. And this sugar are called triose. Three sugar atom, keto triose. The example is dihydroxyacetone. Okay?
What is the carbonyl group?
It contains ketone and three carbon atom. The sugar is termed dihydroxyacetone. Okay? The other example contains four carbon atom. Keto tetrose. Keto contains ketone and four carbon atom. You have to know the name, erythriulose. Take care of the UL. UL. Hey, this is erythrose and this is erythriulose. Okay? There is difference between them. This is a keto pentose. It contains five carbon atom. The example eulose. Eulose means keto. UL. Eulose. Xylulose. Ribulose. Okay? UL is not found here. If you find, it's not found on this side. UL. Do you notice this?
Because this is ketone. This is alcohol group.
And contain ketone group. This sugar contains six carbon atom. It is termed ketohexose. Contain ketone and six carbon atom. The example is fructose. عايز يتحرك ليه يا جدع. Formula is not required. These are the formula if you want to know the shape of the sugar, okay? If you look at erythrose, how many carbon atom in erythrose?
There are four.
Four.
How many alcohol group in erythrose?
Three.
Three. How many aldehyde group in erythrose?
One.
CHO. This is the aldehyde group.
Yeah.
This is aldehyde group. You should find an aldehyde group. Okay, look at ribose. Please look at ribose. How many carbon atom in ribose?
There are six.
No.
Five. No. Five. Five.
Five.
Okay, five.
How many alcohol five. Group in ribose?
Alcohol group.
Four.
Four.
Four. And there is a single aldehyde group.
Aldehyde one, yeah.
Okay. Type. Wait for a minute, please. Wait for a minute. After. Please shut down your microphone because there is a noise. Please look at this carbon atom. Please look at this carbon atom. Okay. Do you find this carbon atom in xylose? Do you hear me?
Yeah, we are hearing you. Repeat that one, doctor.
This carbon atom is called the carbon before the last. It's called penultimate carbon. This is carbon number one. This is carbon number two. This is carbon number three. This is carbon number four. This is carbon number five. Okay? This carbon is the one before the last. Okay? Look at this carbon. Carbon is attached by four bonds. Okay? This carbon has four bonds. Now on the right side, there is hydroxyl group. In the left side, there is hydrogen. Okay? Do you hear me?
Yeah. I hear you, doctor.
Yeah. This carbon below, there is chemical group which is called alcoholic group, CH2OH. The carbon number four, the above carbon number four is the whole of the molecule. Again, look at carbon number four. عمل هنا highlighter. Look at carbon number four. I make it by the yellow color. Do you find the yellow color?
Yeah.
Yes.
Look at the right side of carbon number four, which is attached to the right side.
Hydroxyl. Alcohol group hydroxyl.
It's not hydroxyl.
At the right side of this carbon, there is hydroxyl group. Okay?
Yes.
At the left side, there is what?
Hydrogen.
Hydrogen.
Below, there is
CH2OH.
Are we going to say OH hydroxyl group or alcohol group?
Okay. Above the carbon atom number four, all these structure is found above carbon atom number four. Okay? So carbon atom number four is attached by four chemical bonds to four different groups. Okay? Do you notice carbon atom number four attached to four different groups? Do you notice it?
Yes.
Yes. Don't I have a question?
Asymmetric carbon atom. Asymmetric carbon atom. Attached by four bonds to four different chemical groups.
Exactly.
What is your question?
What is the difference between this structure of ribose and the hexose?
There is no difference. I will say the difference again.
In carbon number three. And carbon number three of ribosomes and xylose. There is a difference because OH is on the left hand side, this one is on the right hand side.
Yes, yes, exactly. Excellent. This is an isomer, it's called epimers. Now, what is the importance of the difference in the direction of the hydroxyl group, to the right or to the left? It makes difference in the rotation of light because carbohydrate makes rotation of the light. Of the light, either to the right or to the left. Okay? Change the deflection of light to the right or to the left. Change in the direction. Okay? We will go outside the room and return again because the 40-minute time limit has passed. We will join the room meeting again because we are going to get outside the Zoom room. We will join again. I will go outside the room and join again, okay? Do you hear me? Do you hear me?
No, I didn't get what you said, Doctor. What did you say?
The Zoom meeting will finish now, so we have to join again. We have to go outside the Zoom meeting and to join again by the same credential.
Okay, it's fine. Okay, it's fine, Doctor. It's fine.
Okay, wait until the Zoom meeting is finished. There is remaining 9 minutes waiting. Please. Then after 9 minutes, we go outside the Zoom and we join again. Okay?
Okay, okay.
What is the meaning of carbon number 4? Carbon number 4 is called asymmetric carbon atom. What is asymmetric carbon atom? Which has 4 chemical bonds attached to 4 different groups. Okay?
If we use this word, different
from CH2OH. You notice
prof.
That?
Hello, Prof.
Please shut your microphone. There is a noise.
Prof, when we said asymmetry carbon atom, I don't mean the carbon atom that are containing different carbon atom group attached to it.
It is called asymmetric carbon atom. What is the importance of asymmetric carbon atom? It can rotate the light because we have xylose in solution. When you direct a light on this solution, the light will rotate to the right or to the left. It makes a deflection of light. Okay? Please look at glucose. Ya baba, fi eh? Nعمل هنا. Look at glucose, please. Look at mannose. Look at galactose. All of them have the same formula. What is the difference?
The difference is the position of hydroxyl group.
What is this carbon atom number? What is the number of this carbon atom?
Number 3.
Glucose is unique. Hydroxyl group on carbon number 3 to the left. Mannose, hydroxyl group, carbon number 2 and 3 to the left. Galactose, carbon number 3 and 4 to the left. All of them are isomers. All of them have the same formula. Do you notice? All of them have the same formula, have the same structure.
But the product is not of carbohydrate.
All of them are monosaccharides.
Doctor, I have a question.
Yes.
Is it not the FMS of carbohydrate, the glucose, amanomers, and the galactose? The structure is not the one that we call FMS.
Epimer of glucose, not of carbohydrate.
Yeah.
Mannose is an epimer of glucose. Galactose is an epimer of glucose. Okay? You find the difference? All of them contain 6 carbon atoms. Glucose, mannose, galactose, all of them 6 carbon atoms. All of them contain aldehyde group.
But prof?
They differ only in the direction of hydroxyl group, in the orientation. Okay. They are called epimers or isomers. Okay?
Prof.
Anyone have questions?
Yes, I have to say something concerning that FMS of glucose.
Yes.
I think if we want to understand it clearly, if the galactose comes in the position of glucose, and the glucose comes in the position of monomers, and the monomers comes in the position of galactose, I think it will be the clear difference. We'll see the clear differences among them, I think.
I don't understand your question. You have to write it. I don't understand your question. The only difference is in the physical property, in the direction of rotation of light. This is a physical property, not a chemical property.
Okay.
Rotate the light to the right or to the left. You know the light like the sunlight. You know the light like the sunlight. It can rotate the light either to the right or to the left, and the angle of rotation is different, okay?
I think, hello, doctor.
Yes.
Doctor. Yes, I think the difference between the is just a...
No,
the difference whereby we have different orientation of Aldo.
I have lectures. Okay.
Hello?
Please, when we go outside the room and return, write your question on the chat box, okay? So I will answer on the chat box.
Our question.
These are ketosis. Look at this group. What is this group? What is this group?
It's ketose group.
Ketone group.
Ketone. There are two alcohol groups. This is dihydroxyacetone. This is ketone.
Yes.
The compound is termed erythriulose. As I said, UL means ketone. UL. You find UL, U and L. Ribulose. U and L. Xylulose. Xylulose. Look between ribulose and xylulose. What is the difference between both of them?
The difference in the position of OH.
There is a difference. The difference is arrangement on the orientation. No. It's arrangement.
The orientation of hydroxyl group either to the right or to the left.
Yeah, different. Yes, yes. Or to the left. Yes, that is a different, I think.
Yes, to the right or to the left. This is ribulose, yes. This is xylulose, okay?
Yes.
They are epimers. I will ask again.
Excellent.
I want to ask you, is this carbon atom asymmetric carbon atom? Please look at this carbon. Carbon number three.
Yes, it's symmetry because different four group of atom attached to it.
Yes, at the right side there is hydroxyl, at the left side there is hydrogen, above there is all this structure above, below all this structure below. What is the value of this asymmetric carbon atom? It can rotate the light, okay? Look at fructose. How many carbon atoms in fructose? I will stop sharing and go outside the room and return again, okay? We all will leave the room and return again. I will leave the room now.
After how many minutes, doctor?
Okay. The Zoom meeting will finish. I will return again and join the Zoom meeting again, okay? I will stop and return again.
Okay, it's fine.
Okay, bye, and join again. Bye-bye.
Thank you so much.